Okay, students, today I am showing some sums from more two exercises. Clear? 3C and 3D. Here some particular sums I have solved and I have given you some homeworks. So these all first you see how it can be done. Like question number 4 I have done. Write the 7 consecutive composite numbers less than 100. See, 7 consecutive composite number. Consecutive means what? Serial. Clear? Serial number in order. So, less than 100, if you find out the composite numbers, 7 composite numbers, these are all these numbers. 92, 96, all are composite number. Composite number means whose factors are more than 2. 2 factors are there. More than 2 factors are there. Clear? If you find out the factors of these all numbers, no? You will get more than 2 factors for each of the composite number. Clear? Next question one is there. 5. Question number 5. Name 2 primes with product 35. That means you have to find out 2 prime number whose product is 35. So it is very easy one. 7 and 5. 5, 7 is 35. Clear? Same way one is there. Name 2 primes with sum. That means 2 prime number whose sum. Sum means total. Total you get 42. So here you see 11 and 31. 11 also prime number, 31 also prime number. And if you take the sum of these two numbers, you will get 42. Here also 5 also prime number, 7 also prime number. If you take the product of these two, you will get 35. Clear or not? Next one is given here. 2 numbers are there. Next one is another type question. Number is given 24. What you have to do? Expressed as a sum of twin primes. You know twin primes? 2 prime number whose difference between is 2. Twin prime. So you have to find out twin prime numbers whose sum is 24. So it is the only one, 11 and 13. These are the two twin primes numbers whose total is what? 24. Next one is given 49. Here three odd prime numbers, sum of 3 odd prime number. That means 49 you have to express in sum of 3 odd prime numbers. Got it, students? Odd, it has mentioned over here, odd prime numbers. Clear or not? So you see, these are the 3 numbers I have got, 41, 5 and 3. You may get other numbers also. So in this way, all numbers are odd. Yes or no? And all the numbers are prime numbers also. So these are the 3 numbers whose sums will be 49. Clear? Next, horse question is there. Who am I? I am a 2-digit number. My 10th digit is 5 and my 1st digit is a prime number. Here 53 also you can write. You can write any other number also. Clear? Next question. Because 5 is in tens place according to question and 3 is also a prime number, it is in ones place. Clear? Next question, I am a 2-digit prime number. The total of my digit is a prime number greater than 13. Have you seen the question? Greater than 13. That means you have to write one prime numbers whose each digit if you add, then what will be the sum total? That will be more than 13. Clear or not? See, 89. It is a prime number. Take the sum of it. 8 + 9, it is 17. So 17 is greater than 13. Yes or no? Now see, if you take 53, it is also a prime number. But if you take the sum of it, 5 + 3, 8, it is not greater than 13. Clear or not? So 53 is not the correct answer. 89 is the correct answer. Clear? So in this way, some of the particular sums, selected sums I have done, and I have given you, these are the homeworks. Clear students? Whatever homeworks I have mentioned, you will do that all in your homework copy. First you will do these all. After that you will do the homework from each exercise. Clear or not? Whatever I am showing, first you will do that. Next you will do the homework in your homework copy, in separate homework copy. Next one is there, exercise 3D. Here I have solved all the HOTS question. Clear? And more one, question number 4. Question you see here, it is given. What least number should be subtracted from this so that the resulting number is divisible by 3 but not by 9? Now all of you know what is the divisibility rule of 3 and what is the divisibility rule of 9. Sum of the digit must be divisible by 3, then that required number will be divisible by 3. Same way, if sum of the digits will be divisible by 9, then that given number will be divisible by 9. So what you will do, you take the sum of it. What has come? 37. But 37 is not divisible by 3 also. It is not divisible by what? 9 also. What you have to find out? Least number. That means one lowest number you have to find out, which one, if you subtract from 37, then that resulting number will be divisible by 3 but not by 9. So can you tell me, like 37, 1 by 1 you move backward, clear? 37 minus 1 if you give, it is 36. 36 is divisible by 3 also, but and it is divisible by 9 also. So it will not satisfy. If you take 37 minus 2, 35, then it will not divisible by any one of them. If you take 34, it is also not divisible by any of them. Clear or not? Now if you take 33, that means 37 minus 4, if you take 33, 33 is divisible by 3, but it is not divisible by 9. 3 plus 3, 6. 6 is divisible by 3, that means 33 also divisible by 3, but 6 is not divisible by 9, that means 33 also not divisible by 9. Yes or no? So this 4 is the least number, which one, if you subtract from this 37, means sum of these numbers, then this condition will satisfy. Divisible by 3 but not by 9. Understood? In this way, different types of sums are there. If it will come in this type of sums, if it will come, you have to solve in this method. Clear? Next one question is there. Write all 3-digit numbers using the digit this. 3, 4, 5. Do not repeat the digits. So first question is there. What you have to do, you have to form 3-digit numbers using these digits only, 3, 4 and 5. And you cannot repeat any digit. So first I have formed all the digits. You see, total 6 will form. 345, 354, 435, 453, 543, 534. Clear? So these total 6 digits will form. Okay? 6-digit numbers will form by using this 3-digit. Now question is, how many are divisible by 3 and why? See, you know that rule. First one you consider, take the sum of it. It has come 12. So 12 is divisible by 3. That means this 345 was divisible by 3. Now you see, don't take the sum of all rest of the number, because here all the numbers are same, only the places has changed. Clear or not? So if one more, first one is divisible by 3, that means all rest of all the numbers will be divisible by 3. So you have to write down the reason why. You have to write down the reason this one. Clear or not? Because here all the numbers are same. So if sum of first 3 numbers will be divisible by 3, that means for all the rest of the numbers it will be divisible by 3. Same sum will be there. Yes or no? Next question is there, how many are divisible by 9? Why? Its sum has come 12. It's for same question. Its sum has come 12. So 12 is not divisible by 9. That means none of the numbers will be divisible by 9. Clear? So it will be none. And then you write down the reason, that one, what I have told, what you have found out. Clear or not? Understood? Reason you will write that way. Whatever you have understood, because none of 12 is not divisible by 9. So automatically this 344, 354, that means all the numbers, rest of the numbers will not be divisible by 9. Clear, students? Is that clear? Next one question is there, question number 15. Find the prime factors of this. Arrange the factors in ascending order. Find a relation between consecutive prime factors. First you find out the prime factors. I have found out, you see, it will here. First I have divided by 7, then 19. So last prime number has come 13. So have you noticed all the numbers are prime numbers? Clear? So its prime factors are 7, 13 and 19. So the first condition has fulfilled. Next one is what given? Find a relation between consecutive prime factor. Find out the relation. What are the relation between these two and these two? See, 7 to 13, what is the difference? 6. 13 to 19, what is the difference? 6. That means what? What is the relation between? That means between two consecutive number means one number is between two consecutive number, the difference is what? 6. Same difference. This is the relation. Clear, students? Now here, question number 4. In your assignment, I gave you like in the star how to replace the number with divisible by a means. In the assignment, you will get it is by 11. Here in your textbook, one question is there. 7, 8, star, 9, 6, 4. May be divisible by 9. So to get the number divisible by 9, what you have to do? You have to take the sum of the number. So take the sum of the rest of the numbers. 7 plus 8, 15. 15 plus 9, it will be 24. 24 plus 6, 30. 30 plus 4, 34. So 34 is not divisible by 9. Is it or not? So to get the number which is divisible by 9, what you have to do? With 34, you have to add the number or you have to subtract the number. Which is nearer 34, nearer to 34, that is divisible by 9, you choose that number. So nearer to 34, it is 36, which is divisible by 9. And to get 36, how many you have to add with 34? 2. That means sum you are getting 34. So with 34, if you add 2, you are getting 36, which is divisible by 9. Clear or not? So in the star place, there will be what? 2. Clear, students? How to solve this type of sums? So here I have given, these are the homeworks. MCQ sums, you have to solve it. Because during exam, you will not get MCQ type questions. You will get sums means which one you have to solve. So MCQ sums also you will solve and you will find out the answer. Clear, students? It is very easy on the basis of all this. So from each rule, one sums I have showed, especially the horse one I have showed, and which are the homeworks I have given. These all you will solve in your homework copy. Clear? Along with the assignment will be in different copy. separate copy and homework will be in separate copy along with these questions. Clear, students? I think you all have understood. Okay, in the next class, I will show the word problems of HCF and LCM from your exercise. Then you have to, I will give some homework and along with that one assignment means additional questions of from HCF and LCM word problems I will give you. So those things has to be complete. Got or not? Have you understood or not what I have told you? Thank you.